Hi, welcome to ASD, App Store Domination, your 30 days challenge. And today is day 3 and we are going to take a look at the developer portal from Apple. So let's get to work. Okay. In the last video, yesterday, I was talking about how you can set up your Xcode project, and I was talking about what this and that means inside Xcode. Today, we are going to take a look at the developer portal. So let's just close this for now. Oh, well, better yet, one last tip I will just commit. Well, first of all, let us just add our remote here. Let's create a remote on GitHub. It will be a public one. Let's push it up. Okay, and we are already inside our GitHub repository. Okay, let's go to source control, let's commit, and let's type in here. Okay, let's push to remote and commit free files and push. And now you know how you can add your project into GitHub, but there are a lot of details. So go ahead and take a look at my GitHub playlist. Okay, let's close this for now. Well, let's just minimize this. Okay, let's go to Google Chrome and let's just type in developer.apple.com, because there is where you want to go if you want to access the developer portal. As you can see here, we have an account tab. So let's tap on that. And you need to sign in. If you don't have, then you need to create an Apple ID, of course. Now let's just sign in now. And you will see that there are two sides of our account. One is this certificate, identifiers and profiles, and the other one is iTunes Connect. Now, under certificate, identifiers and profiles, you can manage the certificates and identifiers and your profiles and maybe your devices. Now, the other, well, maybe more important part is the iTunes Connect part, where you publish and manage your apps. Today, we are going to talk about the certificates, identifiers, and profiles sections. And of course, you could take a look at your CloudKit Cache dashboard. We will not cover this because it is quite advanced stuff. So, and of course, before we go, here you have your membership. You can access your membership data there. So let's select certificates, identifiers, and profiles. And as I was talking about earlier, we have already created, well, automatically Xcode created our bundle ID, well, your app ID, inside Xcode. So let's just take a look at our identifiers here. And as you can see, we have app IDs here. Okay, and let's just filter them out and let's just type in here ASD and hit return. And you can see here we have an Xcode. And if I tap on that, here we have com.rebeloper ASD magic. Now, this, and here we have our application services. And as you can see, in-app purchases is enabled because that is what we did. We enabled in-app purchases. Of course, Game Center is enabled by default. Now, here you have your app ID. If you wanted to make this manual, you can do so by clicking on the plus button here. You can add a new app ID, but I prefer the Xcode automatic way. Now, if you are here for the first time, then you need to create your certificate. Now, your certificate is your link to your Mac. And let's just go to certificates and all. And as you can see, there are two types of certificates. One is a distribution and one is a development. Now, you could go and create a development and then you can just simply develop your app. But if you want to submit this to the App Store and you do have a paid subscription for the developer section of your account, then you need to create a distribution profile. That is how you can distribute your app on the App Store. Now, go ahead and click on this plus button here. And if you want a development profile, then select iOS app development. If not, then production. And you just follow along the steps. And then after that, you just install it into your keychain. I won't go through this because I already do have my certificates in place, but this is what you want to do today. Now, of course, if you here, you have your devices and provisioning profiles, you don't need to take a look at them. When you plug in your device and you have Xcode open and you want to test out your app, you will be asked if you want to allow Xcode to add a device. Here you have all of my devices. I won't go into that because I have my UIDs there, but it can be taken care of automatically by Xcode. So this is what you want to remember. You first, you want to go in here and create your certificates and then install them onto your computer. And that is about it for the most of the part of your development career. If you want, maybe you want to take a look at your iCloud containers, but that is quite advanced stuff. Okay, that is it for today. Tomorrow we are going to take a look at iTunes Connect and how you can create an app. That is interesting. You will create an app inside iTunes Connect. So, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And if you are watching this on my site, then go ahead and take a look at my other products, rebeloper.com/products. And as usual, I will see you in the next one. And don't forget to create your certificates to date. So get to work now. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.